What's going on, guys? I want to talk about this Joe Budden situation, man. I listened to a series of audios, and Joe Budden apparently in those audios, I'll probably try to make play something at the beginning of this video just so y'all can get the gist of what's going on. But apparently he got into it with the co-hosts on the podcast that has since been deleted. And he basically fired them live on the air or on the podcast. And Joe Budden himself is very much so unremorseful, as you will see in these tweets. And I'll get to these tweets later. He's very unremorseful, but he felt like it was what he had to do. Because Joe Budden is a businessman. Joe Budden is running a business. And now it's looking like it's in shambles, just on the outside looking in, because Joe Budden is trending right now on Twitter. And a lot of people are talking about what is going on as of this moment and how this whole thing has fallen apart. Okay, let's get to this article from Bro Bible. It says it appears that the Joe Budden podcast lineup featuring Joe Budden, Rory, and Maul is no more. For the past 2 months, the podcast host Joe Budden has had a mysterious behind-the-scenes beef with his two co-hosts, which led to them taking a break from the show for a month. And what it had to do with was the fact that they were going at it over money. Because whether those two guys know it or not, or understand it or not, you know, that show is a business. And just because you're friends, just because you're cool with each other, right, does not mean that Joe Budden is not going to treat it as a business. Joe Budden is absolutely going to treat it as a business. And he is at the top of the business. It's his business. And the co-hosts, who are his friends, right, buddies, right, they are not in any way, shape, or form owners of any part of that show. They are co-hosts. They are basically employees. Okay? And I don't think they truly understood that. They're looking at the Spotify money and what they could or couldn't get, right? Doing very well on Patreon, might I add. But for the most part, you can never, under any circumstances, bring your friends along with you to start no business unless there is a clear contract where you are both, or three of you are equal partners in it. That was never the case here. That was never the case here. And I'm also going to get to this article as well that talks about the fan backlash. Let's get back to this. After appearing to have patched things up 2 weeks ago, the crew had another blow up and Budden had apparently had enough. On Wednesday morning, a Budden posted and deleted the latest episode of the podcast that was featured him going on a rant against his co-hosts and subsequently firing Rory from the show. We're gonna do this since Rory thinks he has so many options here. He somewhat feels like he's still running the show. He still feels like he has a chance, has choices and options. He feels like he's entitled to more. Rory, you are in breach of your contract. And from this point forward, you are fired and you are not welcome back. So Rory is gone. Budden then dares Rory and Maul to sue him. Everything is good over here. You people can audit. You people can sue. You're going to lose. You both got to move now. That's what it says. Got to move now. Okay. And here's a quick breakdown of the episode that features Budden revealing to Rory and Maul, weren't comfortable with the business side of things after Budden's Spotify deal fell through. Let me just say this too. See, this is what happens when you have guys alongside you for the amount of time that they were together. They feel like the show is theirs. Even though it's not Budden, Rory, and Maul, it's the Joe Budden podcast. And I think that at some point they saw the fan reactions to their shows. They bought into the hype that, hey, we should have a bigger stake in this. we should make more money. Now, I don't know what they were getting paid, but apparently it was nowhere near what Budden was getting paid, because again, he is considered the centerpiece of the show. Now, I know that Rory doesn't like the fact that he's cool with Academics, because Academics is going at him and Maul. But I don't think that Joe Budden is the type of guy who is going to burn that type of bridge. Now, he's okay burning bridges with Rory and Maul because he doesn't feel like they're that important. Now, I spoke about the fan reaction. This is on the New York Post. And there were fans that they don't like to see something that they're used to being changed. Like for however so many years, they've been used to hearing these three together. And they're not used to seeing something different in this podcast, which is going to be different because it seems like this situation is all but done. I could be wrong. They could be back next week, next month, you know, but when you get fired live on a podcast, there's no coming back from that. When you get verbally eviscerated, there's no coming back from that. I don't know how you as a man can allow another man to talk to you the way that Joe Budden talked to them, whether you feel like it's the right move or not, and then all of a sudden go right back to be on his show. You're going to look like a sucker. That's how you're going to look. Now let's get into this article. Joe Budden's venom is going viral. To quote one of his biggest tracks, Pump It Up. The musician turned mouthpiece on the Joe Budden podcast is at the center of a social media shade storm after alleged audio of him firing former friends and show co-hosts Rory Farrell and Jamil Maul Clay leaked online Wednesday. From this point forward, you are fired and you're not welcome back. Budden, who's 40, allegedly spat at his ex-podcast partners during a since-deleted episode that fans claim aired this week. Y'all take that effing dark energy, that arrogance, and that entitlement somewhere else. You see, once again, I tell y'all, man, when your name is on something and you're invited in as a co-host, unless your name is on the marquee too, it's not your show. If you haven't signed a contract, it's not your show. Now, would I sit there and fire them live on the podcast? I don't know if that's something that I would do. But in the heat of the moment, things happen. You know why? Because Rory and Maul left the show. They were disgruntled. And then they came back with a sense of you owe us something. So I can understand Joe Budden losing and saying, you know, forget this. I'm tired of this. Y'all sitting up here complaining. I've done more for you than anybody. You're fired. You're out of here. You're gone. Leave. Okay? I can understand the frustration if you're Joe Budden. We don't know what this situation is behind the scenes. You know, he's trying to do something independent on his own. Or maybe he's trying to score a bigger deal. I just think that Rory and Maul has to understand optics. If you want to control your destiny, you have to go and start your own show. When you're sitting on somebody else's show, it could be for a year, it could be for 3 years, it could be for 5 years. It is their show, it's not your show. So they're pretty much entitled to have as much big share of the money as they want. You know why? Because their name is on it. They have a production team that is working together to put that production together. Rory and Maul do not have a production team putting anything together. So basically, yes, they are beholden to Joe Budden. Unfortunately for them, they are beholden to Joe Budden. And you would think that they would see this as an opportunity, because listen, their hype around the both of them is high right now. Both of them can go, Rory and Maul, and do their own podcast. But I don't think they may not be prepared, not only for the financial, because I don't think it would cost that much money to come together. They can start their own funding, right? Through Patreon, whatever it is they want to do. Kind of like what Budden is doing. People know who Rory and Maul is. They're upset, according to this article. They can go do their own thing. If you're tired of being spoken to like y'all were spoken to, go do your own thing. Go do your own thing. But see, they don't want to build. They don't want to do anything on their own. They just say, hey, we're a part of this show. This show is popular. Let's get paid now. And Joe Budden is like, hold up, get paid what? I'm paying you. Paying you what you're going to be getting. Anyway. Leaked rips of the episode are now flooding Twitter and racking up hundreds of thousands of clicks and listens. And it seems he's now officially ending the award-winning podcast altogether after 6 years. Since unofficial clips of Budden's on-air rants have gone viral, the podcast personality appears to have announced the end of JBP in a series of cryptic tweets. And here are the tweets. He said, hell of a run, God bless. And someone tweeted him, said, you lost me today, Joe, shaking my head. He said, take care. Bad blood between New Jersey native and his erstwhile cohorts begin brewing in March when Farrell, 29, and Clay, 38, were noticeably absent from several of the streaming show's weekly editions, a rarity in the podcast history. Without an explanation for their seemingly indefinite sabbatical, fans of the Joe Budden podcast took to Twitter speculating that money and ownership rights to the show were at the root of their contention. As you can see here, so it's over, huh? And he said, basically 10,000%. Someone here said, Joe Budden, this is the architecture of his own downfall. I don't know how you can be the architecture of your own downfall. I know you could be the architect of your own downfall. Every single time this tweet is still up. Got 1,000 likes, though. Let's see. Joe Budden was on countless podcast episodes talking about ownership and being knowledgeable of your deals, bucking the system, then got mad at Maul and Rory for trying to do these things. Let me go back here. And this is a tweet I wanted you to see. Sorry, not sorry. Because I think this is how Joe Budden feels. I think Joe Budden is sorry, not sorry. And he says, you know what? Y'all are not going to be fighting and fussing with me over money. You can go. And I understand that people may not be used to this. People may not like the fact that Rory and Maul are no longer a part of his network. Maybe he has something else in the works. You know, Joe Budden could have something else in the works. But I do think that these two gentlemen need to take what notoriety they have now and go and start their own platform. I don't understand people who have followings not going out and starting their own online business, podcasting, merch. They could do those things, but they wanted to hang on to Joe Budden, and that's why they're in the exact situation that they're in, because they could have used the last 6 years to build things for themselves, and they did not do it. At least I haven't seen it. Maybe y'all correct me if I'm wrong, but you cannot be on somebody's platform for 6 years and not have something of your own that you can go back to in case this didn't work out.